I can't go any further. There's plenty of different fighters, but they're two fighters at the top of the sport. And a fight with either of one of them is going to be a tough fight, but I can't play any of these guys.
Они были разные. Чем самый модерн. Нету заслуг, там нет больших заслуг того, что они были, потому что немножко намного сильнее было. Я уверен, что будет сложнее, потому что, опять же, разные оппоненты, разный класс. Янченко, давайте смотреть здраво на эту ситуацию. То есть он хотел этого боя давно, он давно готовился. В принципе, вся его работа с тем же Дэниел Джейкобсом, то есть он Дэниел, то есть примерно моей компетенции, Янченко всегда работал с такими соперниками, и готовился, всегда хотел победить бой.
Well, it's going to be very different fights, you know, different opponents, different styles. Also, Divyachenko was getting ready for his fight very long time, so it would be a more difficult fight for me as well.
How does he see it going?
How much does the belt being on the line add to the motivation for this fight?
Сейчас ощущение того, что будет бой, станет немножко другие. То, что этот бой уровня чемпионата мира, вот это самое главное. То есть это бой, чемпионский бой. То есть это будет главное. Как и другие. То есть без разницы, когда у тебя бой уровня чемпионата мира, это совсем другое, не только что у тебя один бой, либо один плюс, либо два, три.
So what is important for me, most important thing for me, this is a championship fight. This is a championship fight for a world championship. So the belt is not as important as it could be two belts, three belts, but most what important is for me is that this is a championship fight.
With the announcement of Triple G promotions, natural boxing coming together. Can we expect certain fighters from their promotion team to be here in
Russia? Golovkin's been able to take a very decent punch.
Я бы хотел бы сказать, что именно эта ситуация наш совместных партнерств помощи с матчем. То есть в данный момент, я думаю, мы находимся на пике, что Эдди находится на пике своей карьеры, что он находится самый сейчас, один из самых главных людей в мире бокса. Я сейчас с ним вместе мы работаем, поэтому, конечно, это серьезный
Well, yes, absolutely. It's very important that we are working together with Machu. Machu, I think, is right now at the peak of its career, at the peak of its importance. And it's one of the most important people, you know, right now. Machu is one of the most important people in the world of boxing. So working together with him to do some grandiose.
So it depends on the opponent.
How much do you enjoy fighting at the Garden?
So, do you
want to
give any final predictions?
How much does he enjoy fighting at Madison Square Garden?
Ну, это уже какой-то седьмой, восьмой бой будет в Мэдисоне. То есть я говорил, что заслужить признание Мэдисона Square Garden и получить такое внимание, то есть и боксер на таком уровне, это самое большое, что может быть в боксерской карьере, когда тебя признают. Давайте говорить о том, что мы не знаем, как боксер, то есть Это классика, да,
Well, of course, it's so important. But of course, it's always my seventh or eighth fight already in Madison Square Garden. To be recognized here, to be recognized by someone who is not from New York City, to be recognized by fans, to be recognized by the audience in Madison Square Garden, it's really important. It's very important for me. So it's kind of also a pinnacle of my career, pinnacle of any boxing career. It's an old style boxing, it's classic boxing.
Eddie, can you speak to the partnership and what you expect to come out of it?
Yeah, obviously, look, since Gennady signed a deal with DAZN, we've been, originally that conversation was with myself, Gennady and John Skipper, and I've always made it clear to him that I'd love to work together. He has his own promotional company, which we're working in partnership with, and it's important for him to develop his fighters, not just on his shows, but he now has the opportunity to develop his fighters on our shows all around the world as well. So it's great news for Triple G promotion fighters. I've been a massive admirer for Gennady Golovkin for a long time. I think he's probably the most exciting fighter in boxing. So to represent him and be on the team is an honour. And I think it was about coming together as a team and taking control of the situation and a strategy and a plan. Don't worry about other people. Don't worry about what other people are doing. Look after yourself, have a clear strategy, clear plan. And right now, he's the guy in the division who has that clear plan. He's got a fight date, he's got an opponent. We know what we'd like to do next, and that's the key to, you know, and for us, it's a privilege to be part of the team.
Gennady, how have your feelings about the business of boxing changed over the last year?
Hey guys, can we keep it down a little bit, please? It's hard to hear. Thank you.
С теми возможностями, что я сейчас приобрел даже с компанией DAZN, с подпиской компании DAZN, то есть в сотрудничестве, опять же, с видением будущего в боксе, я думаю, сотрудничество с нашим вариантом поможет еще больше, то есть однозначно тот опыт, который практически невозможно передать, надо только на себе ощутить.
Well, it's a good question what you ask. You know, of course, 100% changes since last year. First of all, we have a new partnership with DAZN, which is a new vision, a new planning. We have a good partnership with the Matchroom, and it's completely new picture. So it will be completely new plans and completely new perspective.
10 minutes into it, no one's asked you about Canelo. Obviously, I'm sure you've been answering.
Go for Canelo, just for a seal.
Can you just discuss just how do you look at that moving forward? That he is not going to fight.
Давайте я, наверное, скажу только за себя. То есть я был готов, то есть мы были готовы к сентябрю, и хотели этот бой. Все, что касается его стороны, пусть, то есть они сейчас разберутся в своей богадельни, и то есть от них уже пойдет какой-то ответ. Как бы я не могу их комментировать, и не собираюсь. То есть для меня это сейчас вообще не интересно.
Let me say this. As I told you before, I was ready to fight in September. It was their decision not to, so I let them sort their own things out, you know, and let them make their own mind, you know, just ask them, you know, I will move on.
If you don't fight him again for the rest of your career, you're okay with it? I mean, you're disappointed, frustrated?
Наш бой уже сорвался. Если к этой ситуации уже подходишь с пониманием большого, потому что есть отношения с DAZN, есть отношения, есть дальнейшие шаги, то есть жизнь уже продолжается, и надо смотреть на нем. Давайте сделаем так, что на нем не замыкается все. То есть мы будем жить, мы будем развиваться, и я думаю, в партнерстве мы будем гораздо сильнее, быстрее, смелее развиваться.
Already in the situation this fight has been cancelled or postponed, you know, so we're living in a situation where we don't know what's going to happen or not. So we have a new partnership with DAZN. We have new plans, you know. So let's not just concentrate on Canelo. Let's just move on and see what's going to happen.
Triple G, there's one fight that no one's really talking about that I think is very intriguing, and that's with Murata. Before Murata fought Brandt the first time, there was a lot of talks that they wanted a fight with you in Tokyo. And now that Murata got his belt back and he beat Brandt, I mean, I think we can all agree a fight between you and Murata in Tokyo, Japan would be a huge event. Is that something that could be possible in your future?
Опять же, повторюсь, я бы хотел бы делать больше и больше. То есть это то, чего сейчас, то есть я как я и говорил, то есть мы сделали первый шаг, второй шаг, это уже бой за звание чемпиона мира. Думаю, следующий шаг будет еще больше. Конечно, это одна из опций, однозначно.
Она очень интересная. 100%, absolutely. I'm absolutely open for this. And of course, we already made a first step, you know, for his fight, a second step, a fight for the world championship. And absolutely, I'm looking forward. It's very, very important. And I'm sure it'll be a great fight.
Thanks.
Has the undercard been decided yet?
We're working on it now. Gennady's got, obviously, his super middleweight, Ali Akhmedov. We're looking to put Israel Madrimov on the card as well. A couple of exciting fights Luda Bella's looking at as well. So the next week we'll be making an announcement to the full card, but we expect a big show. You know, it's one of the reasons we want to work together, is to give a big show from top to bottom. Last time we were in the arena, unfortunately, and Anthony Joshua lost to Reese, but that card from top to bottom was stacked, and that's what we want to do again on October the 5th. Exactly. That's the three words. Three simple words, but you couldn't have three better words to describe Gennady Golovkin.
Gennady, you had a chance. There was a chance to fight Sergey last year. You were stripped of the IBF because you did not fight him. What's changed now, being that you're fighting Sergey for that same IBF title?
Немножко неправильный вопрос, как понимаете, у меня был шанс. То есть, если так рассматривать, то у меня возможность была со многими боксировать. То есть мы пытались и пытаемся сделать лучшее для зрителей, пытаемся лучше сделать для своей карьеры. То есть мы на тот момент боксировали.
I don't think that's a good, correct question to ask him, if I have a chance. I had a chance to fight with many other fighters, you know, and we want to do something which is best for the fans, so best for my career. And of course, the reason it didn't happen last year is because we were preparing for Canelo fight. Canelo fight didn't happen, that's why the other fights are
Gennady, this is not a criticism, but just to be honest with how people felt of your fight with Rolls. Going into the fight, you know, there was a lot of talk that stylistically you were going to try something different. And